Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room, and heaven nature sing.
At this time, I'd like to invite King Dada and family for the song service. King Dada from Pondicherry.
Okay, happy Sabbath, everyone.
Happy Sabbath.
Okay, very nice to get together and start the Sabbath hours with worship and singing. Okay, very nice to see all the Irvine Adventist children nicely seated in their places and ready for singing. And also like to see a lot of, we like to also see Mamu Mami from Gatshila and okay, from Roorkee, a lot of people joining. So let's start our singing this evening. We'll sing song number from our hymnals. Okay, song number 384, as we start another Sabbath, we want to thank God for bringing us safe through another week. So we'll sing song number 384, safely through another week. God has brought us on this way. Let's all open our hymn books to 384, and we will sing safely through another week.
Now a blessing see, waiting dim is close today. Day of old, the week the best, emblem of eternal rest. Day of old, the week the best, emblem of
what we seek, supplies of grace. Through the dear Redeemer's name, show the reconciling face, take away our sin and shame. From our worldly cares set free, may we rest this day in Thee. From our worldly cares set free, may we rest this day in Thee. When the morn shall bid us rise, may we feel Thy presence here. May Thy glory meet our eyes when we in Thy house appear. Here afford us, Lord, a taste of our everlasting feast. Here afford us, Lord, a taste of our everlasting feast. May the gospel joyful sound conquer sin as comfort saints. Make the fruits of grace abound, bring relief to all complaints. Thus may all our Sabbaths be, till we rise to reign with Thee. Thus may all our Sabbaths be, till we rise to reign with Thee.
Okay, we'll sing a next song from a hymnal, song number 272. Give me the Bible. Yes, 272. Give me the Bible, Star of Gladness gleaming. Okay, this is this is a very nice song. The Bible is the lamp unto our feet and the light unto our path. And without the Bible, we are lost. And we need to have the Bible with us, in God's word with us, okay? Because that is the one that will guide us. So let's sing this song. Give me the Bible, Star of Gladness.
Give me the Bible, Star of Gladness gleaming, to cheer the wanderer alone in tempest tossed. No storm can hide that peaceful radiance gleaming, since Jesus came to seek and save the lost. Give me the Bible, holy message shining, thy light shall guide me in the narrow way. Precept and promise, law and love combining, till night shall vanish in eternal day. Give me the Bible when my heart is broken, when sin and grief have filled my soul with fear. Give me the precious words by Jesus spoken, hold up faith's lamp to show my Savior near. Give me the Bible, holy message shining, thy light shall guide me in the narrow way. Precept and promise, law and love combining, till night shall vanish in eternal day. Give me the Bible, all my steps enlighten, teach me the danger of these realms below. That lamp of safety o'er the gloom shall brighten, that light alone the path of peace can show. Give me the Bible, holy message shining, thy light shall guide me in the narrow way. Precept and promise, law and love combining, till I shall vanish in eternal day.
Okay, for our next song we'd like to sing together is song number 290, 290, 290, Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus. Mm-hmm. So Jesus is the truth, the way, and the life. And unless we keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, we are likely to falter and fail and fall into temptations. And so our prayer should be to keep our eyes always on Jesus in all that we do. So song number 290, okay, Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus.
Oh soul, are you weary and troubled? No light in the darkness you see. There's light for a look at the Savior, and life more abundant and free. Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in his wonderful face, and the things of the earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. Through death into life everlasting, he passed and we follow him there. Over our sin no more upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. His word shall not fail you, he promised. Believe him and all will be well. Then go to a world that is dying, his perfect salvation to tell. Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in his wonderful face, and the things of the earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace.
Okay, we'll for our opening song, we'll sing the next song, song number 308 from our church hymnal, Holy Thine. I would be, dear Savior, holy thine. Teach me how, teach me how. As we sing this song, may we completely surrender ourselves, not partly, but completely to Jesus, and ask him to take control of our lives, because we want to be holy thine. Song number 308, I would be, dear Savior, holy thine.
I would be, dear Savior, holy thine. Teach me how, teach me how. I would do thy will, O Lord, not mine. Help me, help me now. Holy thine, holy thine, holy thine, this is my woe. Holy thine, holy thine, holy thine, O Lord, just now. What is worldly pleasure, wealth, or fame without thee, without thee? I will leave them all for thy dear name. This my wealth shall be. Holy thine, holy thine, holy thine, this is my woe. Holy thine, holy thine, holy thine, O Lord, just now. As a concert's transient joys behind, come thou near, come thou near. In thy presence all in all I find, 'tis my comfort near. Holy thine, holy thine, holy thine, this is my woe. Holy thine, holy thine, holy thine, O Lord, just now.
Thank you, Bhaiya and Bhabhi, for the beautiful song service. For opening prayer, I request Pastor M.G. Kisku to offer the prayer.
Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for the privilege that we have in seeing each other in this mobile. Thank you for giving us the privilege of worship. Thank you for giving us this beginning Sabbath, now that we could get together and praise you and thank you. Thank you, Lord, that with this small instrument, so many family members are getting together to thank you and coming closer to you in our worship. We pray God bless each one of us on this Sabbath beginning hour as we praise you, as we hear your words, as we will be encouraged to walk in your way. Bless each one of us so that we know that as a family, although we are here and there, we don't know where we are, but we are closer to you. Thank you, Lord, for the privilege of this instrument, and thank you for the privilege of getting together through this instrument to praise you and thank you and seeing each other. Accept us as we are. Forgive all our sins and shortcomings. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for the opening prayer. The slight change. Before we go for the quiz, we have a special song by Oliver. At this time, I invite Oliver to render us a special song.
सोने चांदी से भी ज्यादा कीमती तू, हीरे मोती से भी ज्यादा कीमती तू, सोने चांदी से भी ज्यादा कीमती तू, हीरे मोती से भी ज्यादा कीमती तू, मेरे खुदा तू है सब कुछ मेरा, मेरे खुदा तू है सब कुछ मेरा। सोने चांदी से भी ज्यादा कीमती तू, हीरे मोती से भी ज्यादा कीमती तू, खुदूस है तू, रहिया कोई तुझसा ना, तू अजीम है, तू खुदूस है तू, रहिया कोई तुझसा ना, तू अजीम है, जिंदगी से भी ज्यादा कीमती तू, मेरी हर खुशी से ज्यादा कीमती तू, जिंदगी से भी ज्यादा कीमती तू, मेरी हर खुशी से ज्यादा कीमती तू, मेरे खुदा तू है सब कुछ मेरा, मेरे खुदा तू है सब कुछ मेरा। सब कुछ मेरा, सोने चांदी से भी ज्यादा कीमती ये तू, हीरे मोती से भी ज्यादा कीमती ये तू, सोने चांदी से भी ज्यादा कीमती ये तू, हीरे मोती से भी ज्यादा कीमती ये तू।
I'd like to thank Oliver for the beautiful song. It's a very meaningful song that he has sung for each one of us. At this time, I'd like to invite George Hemrom for the mega quiz, quiz master.
Good evening, everybody, and happy Sabbath to each and every one of you. Thank you, Lali Didi, for this opportunity that you have given to me, whereby I could conduct the quiz this evening. And I'm very sure that everybody has prepared well for this mega quiz that has been prepared from the book of Numbers. मैं सबों को स्वागत करना चाहता हूँ, सबत शलोम सबको को, और इस मेगा क्विज में मैं आपका हार्दिक दिल से फिर से स्वागत करना चाहता हूँ। मेरी उम्मीद है कि सभी ने तैयार किया है आज का क्विज के लिए। क्विज में भाग लेने के लिए ज़्यादा परेशानी उठाने की आवश्यकता नहीं है। अगर आपके पास मोबाइल है तो आप जा सकते हैं kahoot.it पे और वहाँ पे अपना पिन डाल करके उसके बाद अपना नाम एंटर करके गेम के अंदर प्रवेश कर सकते हैं। यू हैव टू गो टू www.kahoot.it एंड एंटर द पिन एंड आफ्टर एंटरिंग द पिन एंटर योर नेम एंड देयर बाय you can join the quiz. I would request more and more participants to take part in today's quiz, because I think this is the last of the mega quiz. One more is there, I think. Next mega quiz is on the book of Deuteronomy coming week. And then after that, we have the mega quiz based on all the books that we have studied and taken part in the quiz. So without wasting much time, I would like to share my screen with you all that will enable each and every participant to enter the pin. I hope you can see the screen. And the game pin is loading. The game pin, in order to join this game, is 2288679, and we are going to start this game right now. All the best to everyone. May the best participant win. Question number one comes to you in lightning speed. The book of Numbers opens where the Lord speaks to Moses in the wilderness of Horeb, Sinai, Moriah, or Carmel. The answers have already started coming in, and I'm sure this is one of the easiest questions to start off the quiz with. With only 5 seconds left, I am very sure that everybody is supposed to get the right answer. 14 of us have got the right answer. It is Mount Sinai, and some of us thought the other way around, and they ended up answering wrongly. We will see how the scoreboard has started. And we can see a very early leader, a very obvious leader, Gladwin Tudu, followed by the husband and the wife, Sunny Lena, and Pammy and Kenny. 960 points is the highest to start off with. Next question. Ladies and gentlemen, on your screen, above the age of dash years old upwards, the children of Israel are able to go forth for war. Is it 25? Is it 20? Is it 30? Or is it 21? With 5 more seconds to go, of course, it is 20. And again, the lucky number 14, correct answers. Well, 4 plus 4 plus 1, 9 people thought it otherwise, but then the correct answer is 14. Sunny overtakes Clarion to do. Lina in the third position. Karan appears in the scene and Duga is there in the fifth position. Congratulations for now. Rajiv has climbed up four places and he is the highest climber. We will move on to the next question. It is a multi-select question. The work appointed to the Levites was over the tabernacle of testimony, over all the vessels, or to pitch and take down the tabernacle, or their work was to go to war. It is a multi-select question, so choose your answers carefully with only 2 seconds left. Of course, over the tabernacle of testimony, over all the vessels, and their work also was to pitch and take down the tabernacle, not to go to war. Six people thought that they were supposed to go to war. Well, you're absolutely wrong. The correct options are on your screen. The scoreboard. Lina is leading now with Sunny right behind her. The points difference are very, very less. Gladwin Tudu, Marvin Tudu, two brothers who will, in the course of the game, will give fierce battle to each other. Pammy in the fifth position. Kenny Tudu is the highest climber with the correct streak of 3 right answers. Shall we move forward? All right. We will just take a pause for 5 seconds. We will take a pause of 5 seconds. We have a power failure. We will let the generator turn on because some of the participants will have difficulty in seeing the questions. Please hold your patience for a few moments. Well, yes, the generator is on. I'm proceeding to the next question. Question number 4. Which of the sons of Aaron continued as priests after their brothers died? Eleazar and Ithamar, Nadab and Abihu, Gershon and Kohath, or Gershon and Nadab? We have many answers already with 5 seconds left. We have to see how many get the correct option. Of course, 13 of us have got it right, whereas 10 of us have got it wrong. Eleazar and Ithamar is the correct option. Congratulations to all the people who have done it correctly. Scoreboard. Sunny going down. Mr. Gladden Tudu coming up. Lina is, I think, rooted in the first position as of now. Next question, ladies and gentlemen, it is a quiz. It is also a multi-select question and double points advantage. Who were to be put out of the camp as commanded by God? Who were to be put out of camp as commanded by God? Every leper, everyone who had an issue, whoever was defiled by the dead, or none of the above? With 5 more seconds remaining, I'm sure that everybody will get the correct multi-select options. Of course, every leper, everyone who had an issue, whoever was defiled by the dead are the 3 correct options, whereas none of the above is not the option over here, but 6 people thought that none of the above is the correct option. We should have used a little bit of common sense. Mervyn Tudu in the second position with his elder brother Gladwin Tudu, where the husband is in the fourth position, and Bubbly the friend appears in the scene. So we have a good, you know, top 5 people on our screen. Samiksha is the highest climber. She climbed up 8 places. Wonderful, Samiksha. Let us move on to the next question. Question number 6, a multi-select again. Double points again. What happened to a woman if she was guilty of adultery? The belly would swell, the thigh shall rot, she will be cursed among her people, or she will get paralyzed. Choose the correct options. Not one, but more than one option. 21 answers, 22 answers, and the correct option is, options are rather, the belly would swell, the thigh shall rot, and she would be cursed among her people, not get paralyzed. Seven of us thought that she would also get paralyzed. But of course, that is not the right answer. Unfortunately, that is the wrong answer. And the scoreboard is something like this. Mervyn Tudu on the top. Lena separating the two brothers, Bubbly and Sunny, in the fourth and the fifth position. Thank you so much. Let us move on to the next question. The next question. Who was to say, the Lord bless you and keep you, Lord make his face shine upon thee? Aaron and his sons, the Levites, Moses, or Joshua? An easy one, I do believe. 20 answers already in, 21 answers, 22 answers. Well, the correct option is Aaron and his son, and 12 people got it wrong, whereas 11 people got it right. Aaron and his sons. Let us see. The top five remain unchanged. Sunny is on fire with a streak of three correct answers. Let us see if we have a new winner this evening from the quiz on the book of Numbers. Next question. Question number 8. What covered the tabernacle when it was set up? Cloud, dust, rainbow, or Shekinah's glory? Shekinah's glory. Don't be confused. All right. 10 people think, and they think it right, the cloud. Whereas, how many? 13 people think it is the other options, which is absolutely wrong. Sunny goes up to the fourth position. Bubbly goes down. Jeremy Tudu, you are doing good, but I think you should do a little more better. Let us go to the next question. Question number 9. On how many men did God put his spirit to help Moses carry the burden of the people? Was it 07, 1, 2, 4, 0, or 70? 7, 12, 40, or 70? If we have read it, you would know it, because in the case of numbers, we can't guess. We have to know the number to know the right answer. Of course, 70 is the correct option, and only 6 of us have actually remembered it correctly. Let us see. All right. Lena is going down, and the usual leaders are on top already. Fight of the brothers can be broken by Lena, Bubbly, or Sunny, or anybody else, which is below 6th or 7th position. We have lots of questions left. Oh, well, Gladden Tudu is the highest answer streak of 9. Question number 10. What did God send while the meat was still between their teeth? What did he send? Fire? A very great plague? Hail or lightning? Should be an easy one. 5 seconds left on the clock. And the correct answer is a great plague. 10 of us have correctly answered it. Whereas 12 people have managed to do it the other way. Some thought fire, some thought hail. 8 people thought it was lightning. Very obvious guess. But then it was not lightning. You know, sometimes we think God is associated with lightning, but this time it was not lightning. It was a great plague. All right, the top 5 is unchanged. Mervyn Tudu is back with an answer streak of 3. Question number 11. Who was meek above all men which were on the face of the earth? 10 seconds only. Be very quick. Of course, 13 people know it is correct. Moses. Joshua, 2 options. Caleb, 4 people. Aaron, 2 persons. Anyways, 13 people, the maximum, I must say, got it correct. Jeremy is in the scene. Very good, Jeremy. Where Bubbly exits the top five and Jeremy is in the fifth position. Score difference between Mervyn Todu and Gladwin Todu, very, very less. There is a competition in our hands. Let us see what is going to happen. And even Sunny and Jeremy, the score difference is very, very less. They are climbing up. Let us see what is the fate of the top climbers of this quiz. Next question for everybody. True or false? Should be easy. Moses sent 14 men to explore the land of Canaan. Come on, 10 seconds only. Time is up. 20 people have correctly. Who are those two people who did it wrong? All right. 20 people say it false and you're absolutely correct. Top five remains unchanged. Next question. This is the law when a man dies in a tent. All who come to the tent shall be unclean for dash number of days. 5 days, 6 days, 7 days, or 14 days. Seven is the correct answer. And 17 people, maximum of them, have answered it correctly. Five of us think it otherwise. Three people think it's 14. And one people think it is 5 or 6. Let us move and see the scoreboard. Wow, Sunny disappears from top five. Public reappears. Jeremy climbing on the fourth position. Samuel is making a comeback. Three answers correctly in a row. Let us see the next question. The house of Israel mourned for Aaron for how many days? 3030, 4040, 6060, or 9090. Should be an easy one. 10 seconds, 9 seconds left. Please choose your answers quickly because there are only 3 seconds left. Oh no, oh no. It is a disaster. Only 5 of us have answered it correctly. 30 is the correct number. 12 people think it is 40 days. One person thinks 90 days and 4 people think 60 days. Of course not. 5 people have got it correctly. Are they the top 5? We will see. No, Jeremy had done it a little wrong, I guess. Well, Bubbly goes to the fourth position. Mervyn Todu in the top position. Gladwin Todu following suit, but the difference has increased a little bit. Bubbly and Jeremy, they're having a very close competition, I do believe. Okay. Next question. Question number 15, true and false. Moses stripped Aaron of his garments and put them on Eleazar, his son. 10 seconds should be a very, very easy one. True or false? True, come on, it is true. He put the garments of Aaron on his son Eleazar, who was to be the leader after him, as far as taking care of the tabernacle is concerned. Well, 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 scoreboard, has it a surprise? No surprise in the top five. Next question. What gift did Eliab bring for his offering? 70 bowls of gold, 1 silver charger, interesting, gold candles, or none of the above? We have 9 seconds to think about the answer. Reduced to 5 now. Answers are 21 already. Correct answer is none of the above. 70 balls of gold, come on. Please see the Bible one more time. 6 people think it was 1 silver charger. I'm thinking what kind of charger that is. Moving on to the scoreboard. Remains unchanged. Olia Madi is the highest climber for this particular round. 3 places she has climbed up. All right, question number 17. Who was the prince of the children of Gad? Elizur, Eliab, Elisaph, or none of the above? You have time to think in 10 seconds. Elisaf is the correct option, and 8 of us have correctly answered the question. 7 people think none of the above. All right, let us check the scoreboard. All right, there is a very stubborn competition in the top 5. None of them are trying to allowing anybody to go up or come down. They are happy with their positions, I guess. Last 2 questions. Is it going to be a decider in the top 5? Who was last 3 questions? Who was the prince of the children of Reuben? Elizur, Zuri Shaddai, Gamaliel or Gideoni? 6, 5 seconds left. 21 answers in. Elizur is the right answer. And rest of the options are incorrect. We will see the scoreboard. All right, we can see 1 change over here. Jeremy comes up to the 4th position. Bubbly drops down to the 5th. Number 1, number 2, number 3 have the roots of banyan tree, I guess. 19th question. Why were no members of the tribe of the Levi included in the army? Why? Because they disagreed with Moses? Because the house of Levi had very few males? Come on. Because they appointed to be in charge of the tabernacle? Or none of the above? All right, 12 of us have got it correct, because they were appointed to be in charge of the tabernacle. Very good. 10 of us have done it wrong still. Anyways, let's see the scoreboard. Last moment shuffle? Not at all. Let us see. The last deciding question of the mega quiz on the book of Numbers. How many rods were laid before the Lord in the tabernacle? How many rods? 0, 3, 0, 7, 1, 2, 2, 4, 3, 7, 12, or 24. Make your choice, choices, and not choices, choice, carefully, and may it be correct. 12 is the right option, and 10 of us have got it correct. With this, we come to the end of this mega quiz on the book of Numbers. Next week, I think, Deuteronomy. And I am excited to prepare the questions for the book of Deuteronomy and start preparing from today itself. But for today, let us see what the podium looks like. 3rd position. Lena, congratulations. 2nd position, Gladwin Tudu, congratulations. And the winner for today is the younger sibling, Mervin Tudu, 22096. 15 questions out of 20. Jeremy and Bubbly, runners up 4th and 5th respectively. Thank you everybody for taking part in the quiz this evening. And God bless you all. Back to Lali Didi.
Thank you once again, and congratulations to the winners, Mervin, Gladwin Dada, Lena, Jeremy, and Bubbly. It's nice that all of us were close, and it is a really big competition. I think all of them are interested in, and they're really studying the Bible, and it's good to read and know and learn also. Once again, George, thank you for conducting this mega quiz. Okay, at this time, I invite Mrs. Miriam to share the word of God.
Good evening and happy Sabbath to every one of you.
Good evening.
My spirit, God was with us whole week, and we have got another opportunity to be together or to near God. And we can worship him. Okay, before we start our word of devotion, we'll have prayer. Let's pray. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for being with us throughout the past days. We thank you, Lord, for all the care and protection you have given us. We thank you, Lord, for being with us and taking care of us. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity once again as we could come near thy feet and sing praises unto thee. Bless each one of us, Lord, as we hear from the Bible. Be with us so that we can understand and we can know more about thee. Send your holy angels around us so that we can be more closer to thee. Bless us once again. Take care of us. This time we ask these few blessings in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, I prepared a small thought for this evening. It is about reasons why you should trust God. The reasons why we should trust God. क्यों हम परमेश्वर पर भरोसा करते हैं? Why do we trust? भरोसा क्यों करते हैं? Small word, but it is meaningful also. So here it says, why should we trust God? Reasons. हमारे पास वजह है. वजह है कि क्यों हम परमेश्वर पर भरोसा करते हैं? क्या वजह है? What is the reason? Why do we trust God? And सुनने और देखने में शब्द बहुत छोटा लगता है. It's very small. But let us see and look into the Bible and see it in Isaiah 43. Isaiah 43 verse 1. What it does, it says. क्या बोलता है उसमें? इसमें बोला जाता है, He knows you by name. Let's read. But now this is what the Lord says. He who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have shown to you by name. You are mine. It's very nice and very comfort to you and every one of us. If someone knows us, कोई हमें जानता है, कहीं हम रहते हैं अकेले दूर दराज देश में. एंड इफ समबडी इज देयर हु नोज यू, कोई तुम्हें जानता है, कोई हमें जानता है, तो हमें कितना कंफर्टेबल फील होता है. इवन वी आर रिलैक्स्ड ऑन दैट कि यस समबडी नोज मी एंड समबडी केयर्स अबाउट मी. सो हियर वी सी दैट फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज दैट व्हाई डू वी ट्रस्ट गॉड इज गॉड नोज यू. God knows each one of you by name. हमारे नाम से हमें एक एक करके परमेश्वर हमें जानता है, वो पहचानते हैं. Why? Because we are His. हम सब उनके हैं. ये बाइबल में ये clearly it says, You are mine. अब हमारे हैं. You are mine. So nice. कोई हमें कोई बोलता है कि You are mine. आप हमारे लोग हैं, आप हमारे परिवार से बिलोंग करते हैं, आप लोग मेरा है. सुनने और कितना अच्छा लगता है, बहुत भरोसा लगता है. यस, कोई है जो हमें नाम से जानता है और वो हमें अपना पुकारता है, अपना बनाता है. इट्स नॉट इजी कोई हमें इतना जल्दी अपना बनाए. सो हियर गॉड इज God has surrendered, God has considered us as his own child, as his own. वो हमें अपना बनाता है, अपना बनाता है, अपना मानता है. And he knows us by name. How nice it is. हम तो इतने कोई है यहाँ, पर हम बहुत कोई का नाम नहीं जानते. But God knows us. ईश्वर परमेश्वर हमें जानता है, एक एक करके जितने कोई भी हम यहाँ पे इकट्ठे हुए हैं, सब कोई को जानते हैं. कितना सुंदर बात है. यस, गॉड नोज यू, इवन बिग और स्मॉल, एवरी वन ऑफ अस, गॉड नोज अस बाय नेम, बिकॉज वी आर हिज. हम सब उनके हैं, इसलिए हमें, दिस इज अ पॉइंट वन, why we should trust God, because He knows us by our name. वो हमारे नाम से हमें जानते हैं. And let's see number two, why we should trust God. चलिए देखेंगे Exodus का 14 verse 14 में. Exodus 14 verse 14, what it says? Here it says, He will fight for you. He will fight for you. हमारे लिए वो लड़ाई करता है. Let's read. Here it says, the Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still. The Lord will fight for you. Parmeshwar hamare liye ladai karenge. Parmeshwar hamare paksh lenge. Jab hamare this worldly life mein agar hum dekhte hain, if there is a fight between two parties, और कोई है जो हमारे पक्ष में बोलता है, जो हमें सपोर्ट करता है, तो कितना अच्छा लगता है. यस, कोई हमें सपोर्ट कर रहा है. Somebody is fighting behalf of me. कोई मुझे हेल्प कर रहा है. तो यहाँ पर क्या बोलते हैं, यू नीड ओनली टू बी स्टिल. आप स्थिर रहो. स्थिर रहो मीन्स यू नीड ओनली टू ट्रस्ट गॉड. केवल भरोसा रखो. नाउ हियर इज अ बिग फाइट बिटवीन God and Satan, for you and me. Parmeshwar hamare liye ladai karte hain. Parmeshwar hamare liye ladte hain ki ye mera putra hai, ye mera bacche hai, bacche ghan hai. But Satan, wo chahte hai ki wo hum sab ko unke aur kheeche aur wo apna banaye. And there is a big fight between God and Satan. And here, God fights for you and me. वो हमारे लिए लड़ाई करते हैं. वो हमारे पक्ष लेते हैं और वो हमें बचाते हैं. But हमें क्या करना है? We need only to be still. हमको भरोसा करना है, स्थिर रहना है और चुपे रहना है. Because God is there, who is going to fight behalf of you, who is going to protect you, who is going to save you. So this number two point says He will fight for you. वो हमारे लिए लड़ाई करेंगे. वो हमें बचाएंगे शैतान की लड़ाई से और बहुत तरह मुश्किलों से. हम अपने लाइफ में भी हमें बहुत तरह तरह के प्रॉब्लम से हम लड़ाई करते हैं. And there is a God again. He will help us to reason out why you should fight or why you should trust in God, and there is God who will fight for you. Aur wo hame hamare liye reason out karenge whether you have to be or no. But God is there for each one of us, who is going to fight for each one of us, and we will win the battle. But we need to trust God. We need to be very close to Him. And there's a point number two. He will fight for you. So we should trust God. Number two, it says, He will fight for you. And next, if you see again, why we should trust God, let's see in Psalms 139:17. Psalms 139:17. What it says here? Why should we trust God? क्यों हम भरोसा करते हैं परमेश्वर पर? यहाँ बोलता है, I think about you. मैं आपके लिए सोचता हूँ. आपके लिए मैं विचार करता हूँ. I think about you. मैं आपके लिए सोचता हूँ कि आपको क्या करना है, क्या नहीं करना है. Here it says, How precious to me you all thought, O God. How vast is the sum of them. How precious to be you are. Are your thought, O God. How precious. कितना ही सुंदर है. जो हमारे लिए सोचते हैं, जो हमारे लिए चाहते हैं और यहाँ परमेश्वर पिता हमारा एक एक के लिए सोचते हैं, सबों के लिए सोचते हैं कि हमें क्या करना चाहिए क्या नहीं करना चाहिए, हमारे लिए चिंता करते हैं। और ये है और एक रीजन वाई वी शुड ट्रस्ट गॉड, क्योंकि वो हमारे लिए चिंता करते हैं। जब कभी कोई किसी के लिए चिंता करता है तो उन्हें हम उस पर हम भरोसा करते हैं कि वो मेरे लिए चिंता करता है, वो मेरे लिए सोचता है कि मैं क्या कर रहा हूँ क्या नहीं कर रहा हूँ, कहाँ जा रहा हूँ, कहाँ क्या करने वाले हैं, एवरीथिंग ही थिंक्स अबाउट यू। हर एक वक्त, एवरी टाइम, एवरीवेयर, वेर एवर यू गो, वट एवर यू डू, ही थिंक्स अबाउट यू। कहीं मेरा बच्चे गलत रास्ता में ना चले जाए, कहीं मेरे बच्चे गड्ढा में ना गिर जाए, कहीं मेरे बच्चे पाप के दलदल में ना फंस जाए, ही थिंक्स अबाउट यू। वो हमारे लिए सोचते हैं, वो हमारे लिए चिंता करते हैं, जैसे हम इस जैसे हम बच्चों के लिए चिंता करते हैं। जब हम बच्चों के लिए चिंता करते हैं तो हम लोग और वी कैन और अंदर से हम लोग सोच सकते हैं, डीपली वी कैन थिंक दैट हाउ मच गॉड केयर्स अबाउट यू एंड मी, कितना वो हमारे लिए चिंता करते, कितना हमारे लिए सोचते हैं, क्योंकि वे तो हमें बहुत सुंदर रीति से बहुत प्रेसेस मानते हैं, बहुत मूल्यवान मानते हैं। एक एक जितना व्यक्ति है, जितने कोई हम लोग बैठे हुए, एवरी वन ऑफ अस आर प्रेसेस इन फ्रंट ऑफ गॉड, सब कोई हम लोग बहुत प्रेसेस है, इसीलिए वे हमारे लिए चिंता करते हैं, इसीलिए वे हमारे लिए सोचते हैं कि हम क्या कर रहे हैं, कहाँ जा रहे हैं और क्या करने वाले हैं, एवरीथिंग ही थिंक्स अबाउट अस बिकॉज वी आर प्रेसेस इन फ्रंट ऑफ गॉड। सो लेट अस ट्रस्ट गॉड, हम ट्रस्ट करेंगे, भरोसा करेंगे परमेश्वर पिता पर, क्योंकि वे हमारे लिए बहुत चिंता करते हैं। और क्यों ना हम उसको थोड़ी सी जगह दें, उसको क्यों ना हम थोड़े से अपने हाथ बढ़ा दे, वो हमें पकड़ेंगे और वो हमें शरण देंगे। सो दिस इज पॉइंट नंबर 3, दैट व्हाई शुड वी ट्रस्ट गॉड, क्यों हम परमेश्वर को भरोसा करते हैं, क्यों हम परमेश्वर पर भरोसा करते हैं। और हम देखेंगे जेरेमिया 29:11 में क्या बोलता है, जेरेमिया उन्नो। सो हियर इट इज जेरेमिया 29:11, जेरेमिया 29:11, व्हाट इट सेज, क्या बोल रहे हैं यहाँ, ही हैज प्लान फॉर यू, ही हैज प्लान फॉर यू। अच्छा, लेट्स रीड, फॉर आई नो द प्लान आई हैव फॉर यू डिक्लेयर्स द लॉर्ड, प्लान इन plans to prepare prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. So here it is saying, sorry, it's here, yahan hame bolte hai, God has planned for you and me, God has planned, Jeremiah 29:11 mein. Why should we trust God? God has a plan for each one of us. God has planned for every one of us. Here it says, plan I have for you, declares the Lord, plan to prosper and not to harm you. Koi nukshan nahi, koi musibat nahi. But he has a good plan for us. मतलब हमारे लिए एक अच्छा प्लान है, गुड प्लान फॉर एवरी वन ऑफ अस टू गिव यू होप एंड अ फ्यूचर। गुड प्लान, गॉड हैज अ गुड प्लान फॉर अस। हम तो नहीं प्लान कर सकते, हम तो प्लान नहीं कर सकते कभी कभी, वी हैव डिफिकल्टीज सम टाइम एंड वी कैनॉट प्लान व्हाट टू डू एंड व्हाट शैल वी डू, बट हियर गॉड हैज प्लान फॉर ईच वन ऑफ अस। So whatever we do before planning, we should put everything in front of God. सब कुछ हम परमेश्वर पिता के पास लाए ताकि जो प्लान है हमारे जो प्रोग्राम है हमारे उन उसको हम अच्छा रीति से प्लान कर सकें. Above all, God is there who is going to help us out. He is not going to harm us. वो तो हमें नुकसान नहीं पहुंचाएंगे ना ही दुख पहुंचाएंगे. But He has a good plan for each one of us. वो हमारे लिए अच्छे प्लान किए हैं. कभी कभी we are blank. We don't know what to do. क्या कर रहे हैं हम नहीं जानते हैं या क्या करेंगे वो भी नहीं जानते हैं. We are confused in this worldly life. We are lost in this world, in our work, in our busy life. But God has a plan for each one of us. God has a good plan for all of us. So this is one of the reason why should we trust God. ये एक हमारे लिए एक वजह है जो हम परमेश्वर पिता पर भरोसा करते हैं. जो परमेश्वर पिता पर हमको भरोसा रखना चाहिए, जो हमारे लिए अच्छा प्लान करते हैं, अच्छा प्लान रखें, जो कि हमारे लिए फ्यूचर अच्छा फ्यूचर बनाने के लिए, और जो कि हमें दुख तकलीफ नहीं होगी, दुख तकलीफ नहीं पहुंचाएंगे. बट इट्स गुड फॉर ईच वन ऑफ अस. So let us trust in God and put everything, whatever the plans we have, let's bring everything in front of Jesus and He is going to help us out. And so this is a point that why should we trust God. And let's see in another Psalms 62, 6 to 8, what it says. He is your refugee. वो हमारे शरण स्थान है. Psalms 62 verse 6 to 8, what it says. यहाँ बोलता है, He alone is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I shall not be shaken. He alone is my rock. He alone is my rock and He is my salvation. तो उनके अलावा और कोई नहीं है जो कि हमें बचा सकता है, जो कि हमें जो कि उन पर हम शरण स्थान ले सकते हैं. He is my rock and my salvation, or He is my fortress. I shall not be shaken. कोई भी तकलीफ है, मुसीबत आए, कुछ भी हो, but God is there. He is वो हमारे लिए एक बहुत बड़ा चट्टान है जो हमें हेल्प करता है. और परमेश्वर पिता ही हमें उधार, वो हमारे उधार करता है. सो ही इज आवर रॉक, वो ही इज आवर रिफ्यूजी, वो हमें सुरक्षित रखते हैं. चाहे जितने बड़ा आंधी तूफान मुसीबत क्यों ना आए, वो हमें मदद करते हैं, सुरक्षित रखते हैं. बिकॉज ही इज माई रॉक, वो हमारे चट्टान है. चट्टान से चाहे जितने बड़े तूफान आए फिर भी वो हिला नहीं सकेंगे, हिला नहीं पाएंगे. cannot be shaken. हम अपने विश्वास, जो हमारे विश्वास है परमेश्वर पर, हम अपना विश्वास को ना डगमगाए, ना ही हम परमेश्वर पिता पे हम भरोसा रखें, क्योंकि वो हमारे लिए बहुत बड़ा चट्टान है. चाहे जितने बड़े तकलीफें आए, मुसीबतें आए, स्टिल ही इज देयर फॉर अस एंड ही विल सेव अस एंड ही इज गोइंग टू बी आवर रॉक एंड ही इज गोइंग टू सेव अस. तो ये एक हमारे लिए एक पॉइंट है जो क्यों हम परमेश्वर पर भरोसा रखते हैं, क्यों हम परमेश्वर पर इतना विश्वास करते हैं, क्यों हम उन पर उन्हें पुकारते रहते हैं. और हम देखेंगे लास्ट में और एक, Why should we trust in God? Matthew 28:20 में क्या बोलता है? He is always with you. He is always with you. परमेश्वर पिता हमें चाहे जितना भी तकलीफ है, मुश्किल मुसीबतें आए, कुछ भी हो, but He will not leave us. वो कभी नहीं छोड़ेंगे हमें. कभी हम छोड़ देते हैं हम अपने आप को कंक्लूजन करते हैं और हम सोचते हैं ना इतना करते हैं इतना प्रेयर करते हैं इतना चर्च जाते हैं सो मच आई डू पता नहीं क्या सोचते हैं हम लोग अपने आप को सो मच आई डू बट गॉड इज नॉट हेल्पिंग मी गॉड इज नॉट विथ मी इतना प्रेयर करते हैं बट गॉड इज नॉट आंसरिंग माई प्रेयर हम तुरंत अपने आप को कंक्लूजन में ले लेते हैं हम कंक्लूड कर लेते हैं कि हम गॉड को ब्लेम करते हैं वो गॉड इज नॉट आंसरिंग माई प्रेयर गॉड मेरा प्रार्थना नहीं सुनते हैं वो हम उस पर भरोसा नहीं रखते हम कितना क्या नहीं करते हैं चर्च के लिए और क्या क्या हम लोग सोचते हैं बट हियर गॉड सेज गॉड इज विथ यू ऑल द टाइम ऑलवेज ऑलवेज मतलब हम समझ सकते हैं ऑलवेज आज नहीं कल नहीं या दो पल के लिए नहीं ऑलवेज हमेशा हर वक्त चाहे कहीं भी हम रहे केवल क्या करना है हमें एक भरोसा रखना है परमेश्वर पर एंड ही इज देयर फॉर अस हियर इट सेज एंड टीचिंग देम टू ओबे एवरीथिंग आई हैव कमांडेड यू एंड श्योरली आई एम विथ यू ऑलवेज टू द वेरी एंड ऑफ द एज सो नाइस कितना अच्छा लगता है कभी हम लोग जब कभी हम लोग मुसीबत में रहते हैं मोस्टली दैट टाइम इट्स रियली वेरी हर्टिंग बहुत तकलीफ लगता है बट कोई अगर बोल दिया चिंता ना करो चिंता मत करो हम तुम्हारे साथ हैं हम मदद करेंगे हम तुम्हें हेल्प करेंगे आई हेल्प यू आप तुम्हारे साथ हैं कितना सुन के कितना अच्छा लगता है इट्स रियली बहुत अच्छा लगता है बट हियर गॉड इटसेल्फ परमेश्वर पिता हमें क्या बोल रहे हैं कि आई एम विथ यू ऑलवेज टू बी द वेरी एंड ऑफ द एज वेरी एंड ऑफ द एज अभी आज के लिए दो दिन रुकते हैं ठहरते हैं आपके साथ रहेंगे आपको मदद करेंगे वी से हम बोलते हैं कभी भी बट हियर गॉड इज टेलिंग टिल द एंड ऑफ द एज फॉर एवर वो हमारे साथ रहेंगे बट जस्ट वी हैव टू ट्रस्ट गॉड दैट इज वन थिंग हमें भरोसा रखना है परमेश्वर पिता पर और वो हमें हर वक्त हमारे साथ देंगे कहीं कितने मुश्किल कितने कुछ भी हो बट गॉड इज विथ ईच वन ऑफ अस यहाँ हम जब पढ़ते हैं जॉन 14:1-3 यहाँ एक अगर हम लोग देखते हैं तो यहाँ भी बहुत शुद्धिंग बहुत ही अच्छा प्रॉमिस है हमारे लिए कि जॉन 14:1-3 सब बच्चे जानते हैं दिस इज वेरी नॉन मेमोरी वर्स लेट नॉट हार्ट बी ट्रबल्ड ट्रस्ट इन गॉड एंड ट्रस्ट ऑल्सो इन मी इन माई फादर्स हाउस देर आर सो मेनी रूम्स इफ नॉट वेर सो आई वुड हैव टोल्ड यू एंड आई एम गोइंग there to prepare a place for you and if I go and prepare a place for you I will come back and take you with me and that you also may be where I am you know that the way to prepare where you are going this is yeah our a promise hai ki hum parmeshwar pita par kyon bharosa karte hain ki parmeshwar pita ek din hame ले जाएंगे बट हमारे मन व्याकुल ना हो मन ना डगबगाए एंड ऑफ दिस डेज एंड ऑफ द टाइम में बहुत सारे प्रॉब्लम्स ट्रबल्स टेम्पटेशंस आएंगे और हम अपना मन को स्थिर रखें बी स्टिल स्थिर रखें व्हाई क्यों क्योंकि परमेश्वर पिता हमारे लिए एक प्रॉमिस दिए हैं कि आई एम गोइंग टू प्रिपेयर ए प्लेस फॉर यू जगह तैयार करने जा रहा हूँ और मैं फिर से आऊंगा और तुम्हें लेके जाऊंगा कितना अच्छी बात है सो लेट अस ट्रस्ट गॉड लेट अस बी मोर क्लोज टू गॉड बिकॉज गॉड इज गोइंग टू कम अगेन टू टेक ईच वन ऑफ अस टिल देन वी शुड बी स्टिल एंड बी एंड हैव अ डीप ट्रस्ट इन गॉड तो हम परमेश्वर पिता पर भरोसा रखें जब तक वो हमारे लिए जगह तैयार करने के लिए गए हमें तब तक हम परमेश्वर पिता के जोर बांटते रहे, देखते रहे परमेश्वर पिता के, हम लोग भरोसा रखे और वो एक दिन जरूर आएंगे और वे हमें अपने पास ले जाएंगे। सो लेट अस ट्रस्ट इन गॉड, हम परमेश्वर पिता पर भरोसा रखे और रखते रहेंगे। सो दिस इज, ये एक हमारे लिए पॉइंट्स है कि क्यों हम परमेश्वर पिता पर इतना भरोसा रखते हैं, क्यों हम परमेश्वर पिता को इतना भरोसा देते हैं। बिकॉज वे हमें, नंबर वन, वो हम एक एक करके जानते हैं, बाय नेम्स ही नोज, बाय माय बाय नेम्स ही विल फाइट फॉर यू, ही थिंक्स अबाउट यू, ही हैज प्लान्स फॉर यू, ही इज योर रेफ्यूजी एंड ही इज ऑलवेज विथ यू। So these are the six points. These are the points where and why we should trust God, because He is there for us every time, everywhere, and forever. So let us trust God, and He is there for us everywhere. And हमारे मन व्याकुल ना हो, let us not, हम अपने मन को डगमगाए नहीं, बल्कि भरोसा में दृढ़ रहे, स्ट्रॉन्ग रहे और ईश्वर का आते तक हम विश्वास में बने रहे, ताकि जब परमेश्वर पिता आएंगे हम सबको उनके साथ, हमको सबको लेके जाएंगे। इस छोटे से वचन को परमेश्वर पिता पे सौंपते हैं। आमेन।
थैंक यू फॉर द ब्यूटीफुल मैसेज। इट वाज अ वेरी इंस्पायरिंग दैट वी कुड ऑल लर्न दैट व्हाई वी शुड ट्रस्ट गॉड। ही इज ऑलवेज देयर विद अस, ही हैज अ प्लान फॉर ईच वन ऑफ अस, and he is our refuge and strength, and he is always with us. So we should always trust God, no matter what. Sometimes we fail to do that, but we should always trust in him, because he has given us life and he has a plan for each one of us. Thank you once again for the beautiful message. I hope that we all are blessed by the message, why we should trust God. At this time we have a special song, and it will be rendered to us by Mr. Kulvinder.
Ab sabhi ko happy sabbath. Shunya se leke tune mujhe rach liya apne hi roop mein, shunya se leke tune mujhe rach liya apne hi roop mein, प्रेम किया है अनंत प्रेम से, दिया पुत्र मेरी मुक्ति के लिए, अनोखा प्यार है तेरा, करूंगा स्तुति तेरी मैं सर्वदा, अनोखा प्यार है तेरा, करूंगा स्तुति तेरी मैं सर्वदा। जग में आया यीशु स्वर्ग छोड़ के, मेरा सारा दंड सह लिया उसने, जग में आया यीशु स्वर्ग छोड़ के, मेरा सारा दंड सह लिया उसने, कूड़े खा के क्रूस उठा के यीशु ने, मुझे मुक्ति और चंगाई दे दी है, अनोखा प्यार है तेरा, करूंगा स्तुति तेरी मैं सर्वदा, अनोखा प्यार है तेरा, करूंगा स्तुति तेरी मैं सर्वदा। अन्न वस्त्र और सभी आशीषें दी मुझे उसने भरपूरी से, अन्न वस्त्र और सभी आशीषें दी मुझे उसने भरपूरी से, खतरों सब मुसीबत से आंखी पुत्री जैसे संभाला मुझे, खतरों सब मुसीबत से आंखी पुत्री जैसे संभाला मुझे, अनोखा प्यार है तेरा, करूंगा स्तुति तेरी मैं सर्वदा, अनोखा प्यार है तेरा, karunga stuti teri main sarvada. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kulvinder, for the beautiful song. It's a very beautiful message, the song. It's a great that we could hear beautiful songs with a message. Thank you once again. And for a closing prayer, at this time, I'll request Mrs. Megha to offer the prayer.
Happy Sabbath, sabhi ko.
Happy Sabbath.
आइए हम अपने सरों को झुकाएं और प्रार्थना करें। हे स्वर्गीय महान पिता परमेश्वर, धन्यवाद देते हैं बीते सप्ताह के लिए, धन्यवाद देते हैं परमेश्वर इस सबत दिन के लिए जब हम आपके समक्ष आ सकते हैं और इस पारिवारिक रूप से परमेश्वर आपकी स्तुति महिमा कर सकते हैं। आप महान पिता परमेश्वर हैं, आपका प्रेम परमेश्वर निस्वार्थ है और हम जानते हैं परमेश्वर के हमें विश्वास करने के लिए किसी न किसी बातों की जरूरत होती है अपने जीवन में, किंतु परमेश्वर हमारे लिए आपका प्रेम ही महान विश्वास होना चाहिए। हमें मदद करें ताकि हम आपके प्रति समर्पित हो सकें, आपको तो अपना परमेश्वर करके परमेश्वर अपना जीवन दे सकें। हमें मदद करें क्योंकि शैतान की दुनिया में हमारे सामने बहुत सी आजमाइशें होती है और हम इन अड़चनों में फंस के परमेश्वर आपसे कहीं ना कहीं दूर होते हैं, इसलिए हम मांगना चाहते हैं हर समय परमेश्वर आपकी नज़दीकी में रहना चाहते हैं। हम सबों के साथ हो, हमारे परिवारजनों के साथ हो, इस समय जो इस मीटिंग में उपस्थित है जितने भी लोग, उन सभी को आशीष दें और जो लोग नहीं भी आ पाए परमेश्वर आप उनके साथ भी हो। अगर कोई किसी प्रकार की तकलीफ या परेशानी में है तो विशेष तौर पर से आपके हाथों में सौंपते हैं। बीमारी से चंगाई बख्शें, दुखी गरीब बीमारों के साथ में परमेश्वर आप बने रहें। जिस प्रकार से आप हमें सुख और आनंद और परमेश्वर आशा देते हैं, उसी प्रकार से औरों के जीवन में भी आपका समाचार, आपका सुसमाचार और आपकी अनंत आशा परमेश्वर मिल सके। हमें मदद करें ताकि हमारा जीवन आपकी महिमा के लिए हो सके। अगर हमसे किसी प्रकार के पाप गुनाह होते हैं परमेश्वर, हम माफी मांगना चाहते हैं, हमें धो के साफ करें और हमें मदद करें कि हम गलतियों को ना दोहराएं और अपने जीवन में परमेश्वर निरंतर सुधार की ओर बढ़ सके, ताकि हम अनंत जीवन में परमेश्वर आपके साथ में हो सके। और क्या मांगे, आप सभी कुछ जानते हैं। अगर किसी चीज को हम भूलते हैं अपनी प्रार्थना में, परमेश्वर उन चीजों को भी आपके समक्ष रखते हैं। ये सभी विनती प्रार्थना हम आपके प्रिय पुत्र प्रभु यीशु मसीह के नाम से मांगते हैं। दया से सुने और ग्रहण करें। आमीन।